Good morning, students. So today we are going to study about cancer. In my previous lecture, I have taught you about various types of communicable diseases and the diseases which are caused by bacteria, fungi, as well as protozoa. I have also discussed about AIDS, its various symptoms, causes, modes of transmission, and prevention. So now I'm going to discuss about another very dreadful disease that is generally found in our community, and it is cancer. Okay, dear students, it is generally believed that cancer is a disease that is related with the rich community. Most of the people, they believe that because these people, they have a comfortable type of lifestyle. Their habits are like this. They are not doing much of muscular work. Earlier people, they believe about it. But that is not the case. In today's age, cancer is not only related with these rich communities. It is most of the people from the middle class as well as the poor communities, they also get cancer. So millions of people all over India as well as world, they are suffering from this dreadful disease. So today's lecture, we are going to study about how many types of cancers are there. So here we are studying about broadly two types of tumors or cancers. These are benign tumors and the malignant tumors. Secondly, we will study about the causes of these cancers. What are the various causes? And what are the techniques that are available for us to detect and diagnose cancer? And later, how can we prevent this disease, or what are the things that is done by our body immune system in order to prevent this disease. Okay, students. So whenever the term cancer, it comes in your mind, then you must be clear that cancer is a disease which is related with abnormal growth of the cells. As you know very well, in living organism, growth and differentiation of cells, they are the basic characteristics of living organism. All living organisms, they are made up of cells, and these cells, they undergo growth and differentiation throughout their lifespan. But all of this growth and differentiation of cells, it happens in a controlled manner, in a coordinated manner. But in the disease cancer, what happens? The cells, they keep on dividing again and again. So in this way, masses of cells are formed. And these masses of cells, they accumulate themselves. As you know that such a large amount of cells, they are not required by your body. So if so many cells are formed, then these cells, they always want more and more nutrients for satisfying their needs. Sometimes these masses of cells, they do not accumulate themselves at a particular location, but they keep on revolving in your body. They are the masses of proliferating cells. They keep on attacking other healthy cells, and they also infected those cells and make them cancerous cells. So here I want to tell you that in normal cells, there is a property present which is known as contact inhibition. That means, whenever a cell, it undergoes a function of growth, whenever a cell grows, then generally that growth is coordinated and controlled. How it is coordinated and controlled? That when this growing cell, it comes in contact with another cell, the growth of that cell stops. That means whenever there is a touch between the boundaries of two adjacent cells, the growth of those cells, they become restricted, they control. But this property of contact inhibition is lost by these cancerous cells. These cancerous cells, whenever they touch another cell, their growth do not stop, but they keep on dividing again and again. In this way, masses of cells are formed. And these masses of cells, they form tumors. Tumors means, when so many cluster of cells or masses of cells, they are present at a place. So here, what kind of these tumors are, whether they locate themselves at a particular location or they are revolving in your body continuously. We have divided these tumors into two types. These may be the benign tumors or these may be the malignant tumors. Student, in the next slide, I have written few features or properties of cancer. So, you know, I have already discussed in our body, cell and cell growth and differentiation is highly coordinated and controlled. And in cancer cell, there is breakdown of these regulatory mechanisms. That means they lost the property of contact inhibition. The normal cells, they obey the property of contact inhibition. So whenever a normal cell, it undergoes growth, it comes in contact with the boundary of the another cell, its growth automatically stops. But this is not the case of cancerous cells. Okay, student, here I have written these cancerous cells, they lost the property of contact inhibition. And as a result, they keep on dividing again and again. And in this way, they form masses of cells which are known as the tumors. So here I have shown the picture of so many tumors, the tumor that is located in the shoulder of the person. Sometimes tumors are also found in the brain of the person, and sometimes so many tumors they are present in the breast of the women. So you know that women are generally suffering from this breast cancer, and many of these women, they die because of breast cancer every year. Okay, student, types of tumors, I have already given you one idea that on the basis of location of these tumors, we have divided it broadly into two categories. One is benign tumors and another is malignant tumors. So student, here you see the pictures of these benign tumors. The benign tumors, they normally confine themselves to a particular location. They do not spread to other parts of the body. Thus, it is believed that such type of benign tumors, they are causing little damage to your body. And malignant tumors. Malignant tumors, they generally consist of masses of proliferating cells. Or you can say neoplastic cells or cancerous cells. So cells, they grow rapidly, they invade other cells, they damage the surrounding tissues, and they convert the normal healthy cells into the cancerous cells. So all of these cells, they divide actively. They grow, they starve the normal cells by competing for their vital nutrients. And still their needs, they are not satisfied. So they keep on infecting other cells. They keep evolving in your body. And in this way, the cancer, it spread in the all parts of your body. Okay, students, see the pictures of the malignant tumor. One of the common example of malignant tumor is the tumor that is found in the blood, which is known as blood cancer, malignant tumors. So it is commonly known as leukemia, blood cancer. It is the example of malignant tumor. So here the cell is logged from such tumors. They reach distant site of the blood, and whenever they lodge in the body, they introduce a new tumor there. So this feared property of these cancerous cells, it is known as metastasis. Okay, student, now I'm going to discuss about the various causes of cancer. So, cancer-causing agents, they are known as carcinogens. They may be physical, chemical, or biological. So, among the physical agents, there are so many types of ionizing radiations like X-rays, gamma rays, and ultraviolet radiation. So, when you have learned about the factors responsible for ozone layer depletion in class 10, you know very well that because of depletion in the ozone layer, the ultraviolet radiation, they come on the surface of Earth. And now the cases of skin cancer, it goes on increasing. And similarly, sometimes we are using the process of plant breeding in order to obtain good quality hybrid crops. And here we use the technique of gamma gardens. So the persons who are operating these gamma resources from where the gamma rays are allowed to send to the target crops. So the effect of these gamma rays in that particular area remains for some time. And the operator who generally operates this gamma box, he is more susceptible to get cancer one day. Similarly, a person who is generally operating the machine of X-ray, so wherever that machine is, the influence of the X-rays, it remains in the room for many times. So the person who usually comes in contact with these X-rays, one day he generally gets this cancer disease. Okay, student, chemical carcinogen, there are some certain type of chemicals which are present in the chewing substances. For example, most of the people in India, they are doing cigarette smoking. They take BDs. And sometimes they chew tobacco, raw tobacco. So in that tobacco, nicotine chemical is present. And this chemical generally causes lung cancer and throat cancer in humans. And there are various type of other carcinogens, other chemicals that are sometimes found in your chemistry lab. So teacher instruct you that you should not touch these chemicals with naked hand. Otherwise, it will cause mutations in your skin, because you know that inside your each cell, what is present, DNA is present. And whenever there is mutations in the DNA, then that deleted gene may cause cancer sometimes. So there are some viruses which are known as cancer-causing viruses, and these are oncogenic viruses. And these oncogenic viruses, they have genes, viral genes. And whenever these oncogenic viruses, they enter into your body, they can cause cancer because of activation of these viral oncogenes. Okay, student, another thing that is can be acted as a cause of cancer is proto-oncogenes or cellular oncogenes. It is believed that these proto-oncogenes or cellular oncogenes, they are already present in the body of every person, in the cells of every person. And they have the ability that they can transform normal cells into cancerous cells. It is not always happen that a person easily get cancer, but sometimes when these proto-oncogenes, they get active, they transform normal cells into carcinogenic cells. Now I am going to discuss about the detection and the diagnosis of this cancer disease. So here, there are various type of techniques that are available with the help of which we can easily detect and diagnose the disease cancer. So here I am going to discuss about biopsy and histopathological studies of the tissues that are generally done in case of detection of cancer as well as its diagnosis. So here under this techniques, in biopsy technique, what the doctors generally do. So piece of that suspected tissue where the doctor believe that there may be a cancer present over there. So that suspected tissue, it is isolated from the body of the patient. It is cut into thin sections. And then it is stained and examined under the microscope by the pathologist. So if there are certain distortion or abnormal increase in the mass of that particular tissue, or abnormal increase in the number of cells, then these pathologists, they get an idea that the person may be suffering from some sort of cancer. Another techniques among these are radiography. So here we have make use of X-rays, CT scans, which is computed tomography, MRI scan, which is a kind of a technique which is based on magnetic resonance image. So three-dimensional image of the body is taken by this MRI machine by the influence of the high magnetic field magnets. So in this way, a complete picture, internal picture of the internal organs of the patient is there, which can be easily examined by the doctors later on. And after the thorough study of these internal organs, the doctor get to know that the person may suffer from this type of cancer. So in CT scan, you can say X-rays, they are generally used, and these X-rays, they generate a three-dimensional image of the internal parts of an object. And MRI scan, I have already told you that strong magnetic field, they are used. Non-ionizing radiations are there. And this accurately detect the pathological as well as the physiological changes that are happening in the living tissue if a person is suffering from the disease cancer. Okay, student. After this, we have another technique that is based on antigen-antibody interaction. So whenever a cancer-causing antigen or a cancer-specific antigen, it enters into your body, then the specific type of antibodies that are also produced by your immune system. So what type of antibodies they are produced in your body, the doctors, they examine this And in this way, they detect what kind of cancer from which you are suffering. So there are various techniques of molecular biology, such as PCR technique, which is known as polymerase chain reaction. It is quite helpful in detecting cancers, or you can detect the genes that are present in the individual with inherited susceptibility to certain type of cancers. And identification of such genes, it is quite helpful in the prevention of different type of cancers. So sometimes the doctors, they advise the persons about the particular type of carcinogen. For example, whenever a person buy a packet of cigarette, then it is written on the packet that this smoking is injurious to them. And the person who is later have to do smoking, they know very well that in the cigarette tobacco is there, and inside the tobacco nicotine is present, which is a cancer causing agent or carcinogen. But still these people, they ignore, and later they suffer from throat cancer or lung cancer. Okay, students, now I'm going to discuss about the treatment of the cancer. So there are various approaches which are used for the treatment of cancer. It may be surgery sometimes. Radiation therapy is there, in which various type of radiations are used. And immunotherapy is also there. So what is radiotherapy? So in radiotherapy, what the doctors generally do, that these tumor cells, they are irradiated lithically. Lithically taking proper care of the normal tissues and which are surrounding these tumor masses. That means they are targeting only the tumor cells, and the rest of the tissue which surround these tumor cells, they are protected from the effect of these falling radiations. And a very successful technique for the treatment of cancer is a chemotherapy. So several types of chemotherapeutic drugs are available which can easily kill these cancers. And some of these drugs, they are very specific for different or particular type of tumors. So majority of drugs, because they have to kill the cells of cancer and it is a very dangerous disease. So most of these drugs, they have the side effects like hair fall symptoms. They are generally found in these patients. These patients, they are suffering from anemia also during their treatment. So most of the cancer, they are generally treated with the help of combination of all these three techniques: surgery, radiotherapy, and chemotherapy. So students, I want to discuss a very important thing here regarding the tumor cells. That you know very well, the body immune system is quite efficient and it can easily identify our self-cell and the non-self-cell. But here these tumor cells, they have to be shown to avoid detection and destruction by our immune system. That means our immune system is not ready to kill these cancerous cells, because our immune system knows that these are actually the self cells. Whether they grow in an abnormal manner doesn't matter. Immune system knows that these are my own cells. So our body immune system, they do not try to kill these cells. So in that cases, in order to make your immune system more efficient and realize the immune system that these abnormal growth cells are actually not a well-wisher of our body, certain biological response modifiers such as alpha interferons, they are inserted, they are injected into the patient's body, and these biological response modifiers, they are quite helpful, and they tell our immune system that these cells, though they are our self cells, but they are causing destruction of our other healthy cells and they are harmful for our body. So in this way, they makes our immune system efficient, and later our immune system, they show a kind of response towards these cancerous cells and they start destroying these cancerous cells. So it cannot happen as usual, but these biological response modifiers, they are introduced in the body and they activate our immune system, then only our immune system works. Okay, students. So that's all about the cancer. So here in the cancer, I have explained you that what condition can be considered as cancer, how many type of cancers or tumors are there. So we have well familiar that there are two types, benign tumors and malignant tumors. Then we have studied about the causes of the cancer, various carcinogens. Then how can we detect and diagnose the different type of cancers. And in the last, we have studied about the various techniques that are available for the prevention of this dreadful disease. The students revised your chapter, read your chapter carefully and try to find out the answers related with this topic. So in the next lecture, I am going to explain you about drug and alcohol abuse and how the life of an adolescent, it is related with these drugs and alcohol. That's all in today's lecture. Have a nice day, students.